Welcome to another round of Pokemon Trading Card Game Online here on Gaming POG. We're gonna look at a new deck post rotation. But first of all, thanks so much for all the support and the views on the last video I made, the Baby Buzzwole Garbodor deck. I think right now over 550 views already. And certainly the timing for the video went very well. I posted a couple of days before the World Championship as a kind of rogue deck, which I thought was doing very well on PTCG. Surprisingly, it showed also strong in the World Championship, and so especially the Australian, I think the Australians brought that deck, and I think that piqued the interest and then drove a lot of views. So thanks so much for that. We had the World Championship, we have a German first time as a master champion in the Pokemon trading card game, so that's awesome. And now we are post rotation, so a lot of the cards which we are used to play are no longer available in the standard format. No more Professor Sycamore, no more Floatstone, no more Strong Energy, no more N, so really critical cards. So that has shaken up the format, and I started to look at some new decks. You see here now I only have 11 standard decks. I used to have like 60, 70. They are all now rotated into expanded. So I had a lot of fun trying stuff out. So yesterday I spent a whole day, two attempts to make videos, but they didn't work out. I wanted to do something with Luxray. So Luxray is a card from Ultra Prism, which when you use its stage one evolutions attack, it prevents the opponent to play item cards. And I always thought this item disruption would be a good thing, but the deck is just not yet, it doesn't fit yet very well. It doesn't, sometimes doesn't set up and it's easily knocked out. I think once the new set comes out, once Lost Thunder comes out, we will have much more support for electric type Pokemon, and I'm gonna take another look at it. But I kind of gave up on it, and instead today I'm going to show you one of the most popular decks currently in the format in early playing, which is Rayquaza with Vikavolt deck. And there are a couple of different iterations on that. There is actually one, if you go to Pokemon.com, Pokemon Trading Card Game Strategies, they have one actually posted there, which is already pretty good. And so I did some iteration on it, and then there was also a regional tournament in Melbourne this weekend, and Rayquaza Vikavolt won that championship. And so I looked at that deck as well, and then I built kind of my own combination of the different variations, and that's what I'm playing right now. Let's have a look at it real quick. So I'm playing four Rayquaza, that's pretty much the standard. What's different is I'm playing here also a Oranguru, which the winning deck didn't play, but I think it's important for draw consistency. We have, in this case, three Krubbins and three Vikavolt, and I also playing one Charger Bug. Most decks don't play the stage one and completely rely on Rare Candy, but I found the Charger Bug to be useful, especially once you have one Vikavolt up, you can take your time setting another one up, going to the two evolution stages, have it ready for later in the game without needing a Rare Candy. And then we play two Tapu Lele. In terms of trainer cards, we have Energy Recycler, super critical to get the energies which get discarded from, for example, getting your Rayquaza knocked out, back into the deck so that Vikavolt can pick it up. So just a quick reminder, probably most of you know this, this deck obviously plays heavy abilities. So Stormy Winds of Rayquaza, when you put it down, you need to discard the top three cards of your deck, but if you do, if you have any basic energy card in your discard pile, you can attach it to the Pokemon. And then you have the attack Dragon Break, which does 30 times the amount of basic and a lightning energy attached to your Pokemon, all your Pokemons, which is can easily go into the 200s, 240, 260, 280, 290, I mean, goes by 30. So it can get strong very quickly. And then, just as a reminder again, Wickervolt has a strong charge ability, which allows us to search our deck for grass and lightning energy and attach them to our Pokemon. So they really were made for each other. You see here, this guy needs grass and lightning. This guy just allows us to find grass and lightning and attach. So it's an awesome combination. Obviously, Wickervolt is stage 2. That makes it a little bit more awkward, but let's see how we can do it. So we have Energy Recycler, we use Mysterious Treasures, Nest Balls, Ultra Balls to find our Pokemon. I play in this deck 3 Rare Candy, might want to play 4, but 3 is all I could fit in here. 1 Rescue Stretcher, 2 Switch, so no more Float Stones, and we need to find other ways to switch our Pokemons around. Switch is 1, another option would be here to play Escape Rope, another option would be to play the new supporter Tate and Liza. But for now, 2 switches. And then we obviously have 4 Guzmas, which allow us also to switch Pokemons around. And this is something I play. No one else plays that. Maybe it's not a good idea, but we will see. So I play 2 Hala as draw supporters in addition to the 4 Cynthia. Why? The idea here really is to come out with Rayquaza and use as its first attack Tempest GX, which allows you to draw 10 cards. And then you probably have most things in your hand to set up. Since N is rotated, it is less likely that your 10 cards get disrupted. Yes, people play Judge, so that could be, become a problem, but Judge is not played yet very heavily. So that's kind of really the idea. You come out, put whatever you can do on the bench, then play right away with your first attack, this Tempest GX. And now that you played your GX, Hala becomes actually strong because it says, shuffle your hand into your deck. If you have used your GX attacks, draw 7 cards. So that's obviously super strong, pretty much like better than an N. I mean, it's a Professor Sycamore, but you don't need to discard. So it could be super awesome. And it's 1 more card than Cynthia. Let's see if we can pull it off. I will play 1 Lily, especially in the beginning. If you draw it, obviously it's awesome. Pokemon Fan Club, another way to get Pokemons on the bench. And then, since we're playing Electric, we play here Faulkner, which was really cool. Let's say you have one of the Crabbins there, so you can search your deck for an item card, like a Rare Candy and an Energy, and then use that to accelerate the attacks. And then 2 Choice Band. Okay, so that's a deck, and let's see how we are doing here. Let's save this. Okay, cool. And let's jump into a game, shall we? Okay, cool. So this is Vicarray version 2. All right, let's see if we can get some wins going. I did a lot of testing, so resulting in a lot of losses with some other decks, but this one should be good. Okay, so we are calling the coin flip. Let's go with heads, tails, so we're gonna go second in this game against Mr. Black 2013. Okay, so the setup is actually pretty good, and my opponent had a mulligan to get more cards. So let's put the Rayquaza out and the Oranguru on the bench. We have a Nest Ball, we have grass energy, so we actually have everything we need, even since here. So again, the idea is, since we go second, we can attack on our first turn. Oh, so I see the Charger back here. So it looks like a mirror match, but with Visual Beacon, with a lot of different supporter cards. So this will be a good test to see what's actually stronger. And we get 2 more cards, which is awesome. So the idea here is our opponent starts, can't attack, and then we have even a Grub in here, a Vicarvolt. Awesome. Done. Our opponent starts, can't attack, and then in the second turn we're gonna do Tempest GX, and then ideally we have tons of cards in hand to get our Vicarvolt out and really start attacking early on. So nest ball, we can, for example, pick a second Krubbin. And then we could probably attach one Crass Energy, do the Sins here, see what else we can get. And then maybe get another Grazer on the bench, and then we do our Tempest GX. The only challenge here, obviously, is if we do the Sins here, we find a lot of cards which are good, like supporters, but we can't use, and we do Tempest, we're gonna lose them all. So that's a risk involved here. Okay, my opponent, I assume, searches for a Tapu Lele. Maybe for a Lily, if they play that. That would give them, I think, 8 cards. Let's see what he plays. Tapu Lele for... Faulkner. Okay. So... Okay. He can't obviously use... He can't evolve yet, so... Kind of interested what he's looking for, what item card he thinks he's missing. It's an unusual move. I would have expected cross support or maybe he has something. So he looks for the rare candy and the lightning energy. Okay, obviously he knows that I can't disrupt his 4 cards. Fine. We're gonna go here with a nest ball, pick another Krubbin. Put on the bench, attach a grass energy, and then, yeah, then we're gonna play Cynthia here. See what else we can get. That's good in Ultra Ball. We really don't need the Pokemon Fan Club, and we can probably discard one of the grass energies. And with that, let's find another Rayquaza. So we get set up. Rayquaza to the bench. And yeah, I think we want to leverage the energy here. So, okay, Cynthia, Tapu Lele. And with that, we can attach a grass energy. Okay. And we have a rescue stretcher, which. Oh, that was a. Discard Tapu Lele, that doesn't help us since we're gonna play Tempest GX, which discards the rest of our hand. Okay. Okay, so we have a rare candy, we have an Ultra Ball, so we have really everything ready to get. We have a Mysterious Treasure, even if we want to get another Rayquaza, to get our own Vikavolt out. Okay, so he has. His Vikavolt out and an additional Rayquaza. The question is, does he have a draw supporter or is he stuck with kind of one card? Okay, he has a copycat. That's good for him because he gets. Okay, so that gives me a surprise in it. So what's Wishful Baton? He can move. He's surprised as well. Wishful Baton knocked out by damage. Move up to 3 energy cards from that Pokemon to another bench Pokemon. Okay. So obviously pretty useful. So let's see if he can do the knockout. 3, 4, 4 times 30. It's 120 for now. Okay. There are a lot of things which we could do. We could go for his Vikavolt. Yeah, probably not. just trying to think if there's some ways how we can knock him out. 1, 2, we're gonna attach 3, so that's 5, 150. Plus we can find another Rayquaza, get another energy, so that would be a knockout, okay. I think that should be fine. Okay, Dragon Break for 120. Fine. So, we definitely can, what do we want? We want an Ultra Ball. We don't need the Grubbin anymore. We don't need a Nest Ball. Setup time is over, but we want a Wickerwald. Okay. And then we want to Rare Candy on top here. Potentially we could even get another one, Mysterious Treasure. No, that's a way to get a Rayquaza. So the question is here, do we want to use Guzma to knock out something here? So he loses one energy, he comes back, attaches, or we want him. If he knocks this out, he keeps all his energies. I think what I want to do is actually, let's see here, 1, 2, 3. Yeah. What I want to do is I want to Guzma this guy, bring this Rayquaza out, and then we want to do the strong charge. What do we need actually to play that? So we need electric mainly. Okay. Oh, okay. We can only pick two. Strong charge on this guy. And then we want to Mysterious Treasure. Four. Rare Candy now. Maybe it's a Tapu Lele. Bring out another Rayquaza. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 6 times 30, 180. Yeah, that should work. So yes, we need this, even though we lose some valuable Pokemon. Attach this guy, and then attach a grass. And then we are ready for a Dragon Break for the knockout here. Okay. I'm gonna take the first two prize cards. We have a Rare Candy and a Volkner. And now our opponent can bring two more, let's say 3 energy, then he has 6, so he can knock out, he can do one hit knockout. And then we have 1, 2, 3, plus 2, then we can do 6 and we do another knockout. So we should be ahead in this game. Let's see what he comes up with. Okay, Rescue Stretcher for the Rayquaza, bring it back, attach. Yeah, that's fine. The problem is the Wishful Baton. That's really annoying. And we don't play Field Blow or anything, so we have no way to avoid it except kind of going for Pokemon on the bench. Let's see if the Wishful Baton really can make a difference for him or not. Okay, and then electric energy. There's then the Wickerwald to load something up on the bench. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I mean, definitely for the knockout, 7 times 30, 210. So that's not a problem for him. We probably, do we need to energy recycler something? We have 2 energy recyclers. Blah, 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 1 plate, but right now there's actually no energy in this card pile, so that's pretty good. 210. So now we need to do another 180. Okay, two Faulkner. So what can we do? 1, 2, 3. We can attach one and then attach to this guy. Okay. Boom. We need to Faulkner anything, an item card. Is there any item card which we could need? I guess we can try. But first let's do the strong charge. Okay. Let's pick one of each. Get this guy ready. Since this guy potentially can take the final knockout. Can't attach. Can we get another Rayquaza up? We play for. Let's do the Faulkner here. Energy recycle, no. Mysterious treasure would give us a Rayquaza. Or a choice band, potentially. Which we don't really need. Let's see if we have a Rayquaza. Ooh, boo, 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 boo. Yeah. Let's just get another Rayquaza up and running. I think this is the best option for us. So choice band and electric energy. So that's our last electric, and there's one more grass left. Ooh, yeah. I get it, I get it, I get it. Time is running out. Choose a card, this card, rare candy, Rayquaza, boom. And then boom. And then 1, 2, 3. No, let's not do this. And then Dragon Break for some other. Okay. We have another Faulkner, which gives us our energy recycler, which then should be enough to knock out his last Rayquaza if he decides to play it. So let's say he brings another Rayquaza out, he knocks out this one, then we should be able to get attach one from hand, use Faulkner to find energy recycler, bring energies back, Wicker Vault, boom. Okay. For the game. So as you can see, these are actually, except me playing slow, fast games. It's like GX knockout, GX knockout, GX knockout. So that's kind of the fun part about it. It's like really like just accelerate energies. But as we can see, unless my opponent comes up with some shenanigans, while he has Wishful Baton and he can attach, obviously he can now do huge damage, doesn't really matter. As long as I do 180, I mean, I still have a choice band probably somehow, which I could also just use. But as long as I make 180, it doesn't matter if you have 20 energies on your Pokemon. You just need the 6 or 3 plus choice band. 5 plus choice band. So we're gonna lose those 3. I guess the only way for him, if he knocks out our Wickervolt, no. Then we just come back with Rayquaza. Can he, like, if he had a disruption card for our hand, like a Judge, then the Faulkner would go, but typically these decks don't play Judge, so I doubt he has it. So this is, I think, good game. So yeah, we can bring out anything. I don't want to make a mistake here, but okay, let's just bring out this guy. Just in case something goes completely wrong. So we have the choice band already. Okay, let's make no mistake here. Use the Faulkner, energy recycler, boom, boom. Get our energies back. Boom, and that's a win. All right, so fun deck to play. Rayquaza, Vikavolt, certainly a strong force to be reckoned with. There are a couple of other decks I want to feature in my next videos. One is Christopher Szymanski, I think, showed a couple of decks on Six Prizes. So if you're interested in strategy, sixprizes.com. I'm just looking over here on my iPad if I have this right, sixprizes.com. A couple of good decks posted. His article posted one day ago, The Sun and the Moon, really good analysis of the possible decks after the new rotation. And one which I built from his description is this one here. Let me go in another deck manager, which is like a Zoroark counter deck with the idea to go be behind in prize casters, start out with a Tapu Koko, spread damage around, and then once your Tapu Koko gets knocked out, you're gonna start coming from behind and use a lot of things like Shaman. You can use things like Mimikyu and then supporter cards like Countercatcher and so on, which all make you stronger when you're behind in prize cards and can lead you to the win. So that's kind of a fun deck I played a little bit with. I want to feature on the YouTube channel. Other decks, if you go back here, which I've been looking at, Zoroark Shiftry. So it's an okay deck, but it's still not kind of the strongest deck out there. Kind of like the idea of Shiftry to play with. And there are a couple of more things to be played. So two other concepts which I saw, if we go here into collection. There is a Zoroark Delcaddy Cat. Okay, so this sounds like super weird, but I played against it and it seemed to work pretty well. So it uses which one? Yeah, it uses this Delcaddy here with the Search for Friends ability. When you play this Pokemon from your hand to evolve one of your Pokemon during your turn, you may put two supporter cards from your discard pile into your hand. So it's pretty much two VS Seekers. So you play this, bring back supporter cards, and then you play kind of cards like Acerola and a Rainbow Energy, which allow you to bring this back in your hand and then do it over and over again, bringing back supporter cards. And a key supporter card you play here is then Mellow. So for Mellow, you can then pick the top two cards, any top two cards, put on top of your deck, use Zoroark to get those cards, and then search for friends, put back the Mellow into the deck and then find it again and kind of try to rinse and repeat, so to speak, have a whole cycle going. So that was kind of interesting. The other deck which has seen a lot of play, at least online I see it, is a Zoroark with, and now I can't think of the name, the other dark type Pokemon, which pretty much allows for disruption, where it does 50 times the amount of Pokemon which have abilities on your opponent's side. And since, as you see, for example, with a Rayquaza deck, every Pokemon has abilities that can easily generate 250 damage for a single prize attacker. So that's another deck which I want to play out. But I think that's all for today. If you know what Pokemon I'm talking about, let me know in the comments. I'm just planking out right now. And with that, have a great day and see you guys later. Bye.